Hello, my name is Kumar Askan Pandey and I'm a faculty at Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia National University. Today, we shall be talking about the correctional system as applicable in India. Many ideas which are sweeping the criminal justice system in this country all focus on how to correct an individual who, on account of a mistake of his life, has been declared as unwanted and has been removed from the mainstream of the society. Oscar Wilde once famously said that every saint has a past and every sinner a future. Hate the sin and not the sinner is also an old adage of biblical origin. These clearly underline that every civilized society must be able to reclaim and reintegrate into its mainstream a human resource lost on account of his or her criminality and must make all possible efforts towards this end. Punishing an individual for a criminal act is not an end in itself, it is only a means towards an end, and that is reformation and correction of such an individual. As early as in 1920, the Indian Jails Committee had underlined that the reformation and rehabilitation of offenders is the ultimate objective of prison system in this country. Even at the global level, efforts have been made to make correctional system humane and purpose oriented. In 1955, the United Nations Standard Minimum Rules for the Treatment of Prisoners provided the basic framework for achieving the above stated object. Further, under the aegis of the United Nations, the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, ICCPR, propounded in 1977, to which India is a party, emphasized that the correctional system's essential aim shall be prisoners' reformation and social rehabilitation. After having discussed all the issues pertaining to the correctional system in this country, the learner shall have a fair idea about the correctional system within the realm of the criminal justice administration. They shall also become familiar with the system of traditional closed prisons, parole, probation, furlough, open prisons, etc., and the correctional system for the juvenile delinquents as well. Correctional system in India is comprised of institutions, policies, laws, norms and practices, which all aim at bringing the offender back to the society as a better human being and making him realize that crime never pays. The laws, practices and procedures of correctional system are scattered in various statutes, rules, regulations and case law. In Ramamurthy versus State of Karnataka, AIR 1997 Supreme Court 1739, the Supreme Court underlined the need to prepare an All India Prison Manual. Now, we all know that prisons, reformatories, borstal institutions, etc. are included in the state list 2 of the 7th schedule of the Constitution of India, and therefore, the laws, practices which govern the correctional system in different states may differ from each other. In fact, in the year 2003, the Bureau of Police Research and Development, an apex research institution of the Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India, prepared an All India Model Prison Manual, which was supposed to be adopted by all the states in India in making those manuals responsive to the changing needs of the society as well as of the convict. However, no progress yet has been made on that front for the obvious reasons. The prison system in India, in the contemporary modern sense of the closed prisons, has its origin in the British period when the Prisons Act of 1894 was created. Unfortunately, the basic legislative framework of prison system in India is still governed by this archaic law. However, different states have formulated their own prison manuals for the day-to-day administration of their prisons, but all these prison manuals derive their authority and jurisdiction from the Prisons Act of 1894 alone. The traditional closed prisons in India are mainly of three types. The first kind is that of central prisons, the second is district prisons, and the third one is sub prisons. The prison system in India, in the contemporary modern sense of the closed prisons, has its origin in the British period when the Prisons Act of 1894 was enacted. Unfortunately, the basic legislative framework of the prison system in India is still governed by the same act. However, different states have formulated their own prison manuals for the day-to-day administration of their prisons. All these prison manuals derive their authority from the same archaic law, the Prisons Act of 1894. In India, traditional closed prisons are principally of three types. The first is the central prison, the second is the district prison, the third is sub-prison. There may also be certain special prisons, for example, prisons which are exclusively meant for female convicts, borstal institutions, and special prisons as well. As far as infrastructure is concerned, the central prisons are better equipped to receive hardened criminals and convicts who have been given life imprisonment or imprisonment of more than 7 years. District prisons not only lodge convicts but also have a sizable population of under trials. Mostly under trials are lodged in sub prisons. Now let's have a look as to number of prisons in this country in the year 2012. According to the data released by National Crime Records Bureau in the year 2012, there were 127 central jails, 340 district jails, 806 sub jails, 20 exclusive prisons for women, 46 open prisons, 21 borstal schools, 31 special jails, and there were 3 other prisons. Total number of jail inmates as on 31st of December 2013 was 385,135. Out of this population, the male prisoners were 368,184. That shall be 95.6%, whereas the population of female prisoners was a mere 16,951, that would be 4.4% of the entire prison population of India. Now, it is also to be remembered that the biggest problem of Indian prisons today is overcrowding. The data shows that in 2010, the occupancy rate was 115.1%, which slightly fell to 112.1% in the year 2011 and slightly rose to 112.2% in the year 2012. It is also very important for us to note that 70% of the prison population is that of under trials.